circulations corresponding to this delta connection. B part of this problem is corresponding to delta connection. So in case of this, line voltage and phase voltage both are same, 400 volts. And we have calculated the impedance of the circuit, that was 17.7 ohms. So these two are already available with us. Now in case of this phase current, we have to calculate phase current. That is nothing but current per phase. And this is nothing but 400 volts divided by 17.7 ohms. Because voltage is 400 volts now, it is not 231, and here the impedance is 17.7. If you divide this, we will be getting the current, which is around 22.6 amperes. 22.6 amperes of current is flowing from the phase. Now, for calculating the power consumption, so we need to calculate the line current also, right? Line current is, in case of delta connection, line current IL is equal to root 3 into phase current I phase. Root 3 is 1.732 into 22.6. If you make calculation, you will get the value of the line current. Line current comes out to be 39.14 amperes. 39.14 amperes is the current. So line current, phase current are different. Here phase voltage. There line voltage and phase voltage are different. The power absorbed, P is equal to root 3 into VL into IL into cos phi. Root 3 is 1.732, VL is 400, right, into IL is 39.14, first with the line current. Cos phi is 0.847, we got this value already, right. So this, if you substitute here in this one, it comes up to be 22,968 watts. 22,968 watts. Since it is in terms of thousands, we can convert this into kilowatts. 22.968 kilowatts of power. So this is the maximum value of the power that is being absorbed here. Whereas in the case of the star connection, the power absorbed was only 7 point something. That is just a little bit. It is 7.632 kilowatts, and here it is 22.968 kilowatts. Therefore, power consumption is more in case of delta connection compared to power in case of star connection. Right? Power consumed by the circuit is more in case of delta connection compared to star connection. That is also clearly understood with the help of this problem. Now, let us go ahead with the power in three phase systems. How this power measurement is done in case of three phase systems? So, what are the methods? So, the two methods normally we employ in practical purposes for measuring the power in case of three phase systems is are 2 watt meter method and 3 watt meter. This 2 watt meter method is basically used in case of three phase and three wire balanced or unbalanced star or delta connected circuit. So we can have either star connection or delta connection, but the load also can be a balanced or unbalanced circuit. So in this case, some calculations are given here, but before going to do that, let us have a look at how these connections are made, right? So in case of three phase power measurement using two watt meters, how these connections are made, there is an important thing. So you can just look at here, this is the three phase supply, right, which is connected in star, right? This is the power supply, this is the single one phase V1S. This is V2S, this is V3S. This is first phase, second phase and third phase. All are connected in star connection. Therefore, there is a neutral point available here as N. Now, this is connected again to a delta connected load. It is not star connected load, and your supply is star connected, but your load is delta connected load. Or, of course, you can also connect it to star connection. There is nothing wrong with that. Your load can be either star or delta. That's what we have seen in the. This method can be used both for the star connection connected load as well as delta connected load. Now, when I make this delta connected load connected to this three phase supply, and when power flows from the supply, three phase supply to the three phase load, right, then the power measurement which is consumed by this three phase load is measured basically by the two watt meters connected here in the figure. You just see here, and from this point this is connected to wattmeter, and from this AC supply this is connected to, and the second wattmeter is connected here with the second phase connected to this end, and the second supply is connected to this end, and the third phase is connected common to the third point left over in the three phase load and to the common point of both the wattmeters. Right, the connection is very important. This diagram is very clear how the connections are to be made for making the measurements. Now this wattmeter 1, which is measuring the power, right, is basically, let us say it is P1, and the second wattmeter which is measuring the power in the circuit is, let us say it is P2. Then the total power which is to be calculated here is given. P1 is given by this equation. What is that equation? V12 into I1 into cos 30 plus theta, that is V line into I line into cos 30 plus theta, and P2 is the power, that is of the second one, V32 into I3 into cos 30 minus theta is equal to V line into I line into cos 30 minus theta. So therefore, the power P1 is nothing but the line voltage V and line current I product multiplied by cos of 30 plus theta, where theta is the phase difference between this, and then this P2 is also basically having the same terms in its voltage and current, that is V line and I line product multiplied by cos 30 minus theta, that is the difference between these two powers. Now when I take the total power calculation is done by taking the P1 plus P2, that is nothing but V line I line cos 30 plus theta plus V line I line cos 30 minus theta. So here cos 30 plus theta can be expanded and cos 30 minus theta can be expanded, and if you take the calculations here, it is found that its value is root 3 into V line I line cos theta. That is the total power consumed by the three phase supply connected in star to a load connected in delta will be equal to root 3 times line voltage and line current product and multiplied by this cos theta, where theta is the phase angle between this voltage and currents. Clear about this? This method is used for making measurements in star as well as delta connected loads, balanced or unbalanced loads. Right? This is about the 2 wattmeter method. Now, when I go for the second method, that method is called as the 3 wattmeter method. So, in case of 3 wattmeter method, we use 3 phase 4 wire star or delta connected circuit. This circuit particularly used basically for 3 phase 4 wire star connected or delta connected circuits. And in this, the total power is calculated as the sum of all the three individual powers measured by the 3 wattmeters connected in the circuit. So before going to study about this formula explanation, we can just have how these 3 wattmeters are connected in a practical system. So in a practical system, the 3 wattmeters are connected in such a way that the first phase, that is VS1S, is connected to the first wattmeter, wattmeter 1, right? And here load and the supply both are of same vertical connection, that is it is also star connected and this is also star connected, and therefore here you can see here the first phase is connected to wattmeter 1 and the wattmeter 1's other end is connected to the one end of the load here in the circuit. Similarly, the second phase V2S is connected to second wattmeter, V3S is connected to the second wattmeter and its end is connected to the other end of the load. And similarly, the third phase is connected to the wattmeter and it is also connected to the other end of the load. And the neutral of this load is connected as a common point, which is connected to the neutral of the supply. That means this N is representing this N. That means this connection is going to this point, indicating that the two neutrals are connected together with reference to which we measure the powers of all the three phases separately by the three wattmeters, namely wattmeter 1 and wattmeter 2 and wattmeter 3. The power measured by wattmeter 1 is designated as P1, and the power measured by wattmeter 2 is designated as P2, and the power measured by wattmeter 3 is designated as 3. And since all the three powers are available for us as P1, P2, P3, the total power consumed by this three phase circuit can be taken as the sum of P1, P2 and P3. Therefore, the total power consumed here in this circuit can be written as the total power, right? Is P1 plus P2 plus P3. So how we are getting? Q1 is being measured by the wattmeter 1, P2 is being measured by the wattmeter 2, P3 is being measured by the wattmeter 3. Therefore, 3 wattmeters and 3 powers are readily available for us. Therefore, we can just simply sum them up to get the total power consumed by this 3-phase supply. I hope it is clear. Now, we can just have some problems related to this power measurement using wattmeters. Of course, I just given the diagrams here. Now, this power, the problems we are going to do will help us to see what are the formulae that we need to remember for making calculations in case of this 3-phase power measurement. Problems related to power measurement. Right? Problem that we have here is, I have got two problems for this. 2 wattmeters connected to measure the power input to a 3-phase circuit indicates 15 kilowatts and 1.2 kilowatts respectively. That means this problem is pertaining to 2 wattmeter method, and in this the wattmeter 1 is measuring a power P1 which is 15 kilowatts, right? And the other power, other meter is representing the power as 1.5 kilowatts. 2 meters are measuring 2 different powers here. The latter reading being obtained after reversing the current coil connections. So here for wattmeter there will be coils which have to be connected in some specific fashion, and here if the reversing of the coils is done here, then the values will be opposite to what they are. That means there will be negative sign for the currents. Calculate the power and power factor of the load. So this is the problem, and now let us see what is the solution for this problem. So reading in the first wattmeter W1, and of course here I have written as P1, right? So since wattmeter is used, he is using the word W1, and if you also ignore P1 also, because it is basically the power. So W1, W2 are the 2 powers which are being measured by the 2 wattmeters. Now the total power fed to the load. What is the total power fed to the load? Total power fed to the load is nothing but basically the sum of these two, W1 plus W2, that is 15 plus 1.5, that is 16.5 kilowatts. Right? This is the total power that we can have. Of course, it is not 16.5. Why? The mistake we have made here is, I'll tell you about this. Since for second wattmeter, the coils are reversed here, the value of the power that is to be taken here must be minus 1.5. Therefore, it is 13.5 watts. This is very important. The total power fed to the load will become 13.5. It is not simply the algebraic sum of the two powers. The reason is the wattmeter 2 coils, current coils, are reversed. Because of that, the negative sign is coming into picture. Now, in case of this 3 power measurement, there is one important formula. That formula is called as tan phi, is given by root 3 into W1 minus W2 by W1 plus W. This is very important formula that you have to remember here. Of course, I am not doing the derivation part of this particular thing. The reason is, it's very complicated. Therefore, I just would like to restrict the formula. The formula is tan phi is equal to root 3 W1 minus W2 by W1 plus W2. This is the formula for making the calculation with respect to the tan phi. Now, if I substitute this value here, root 3 into W1 is how much? It is 15. Minus W2 is 1.5 divided by W1 plus 2, 15 plus 1.5. So if I make calculations corresponding to this tan phi, the value comes out to be 2.117. So tan phi value is 2.117. Therefore, from the tan tables or by using the calculator, we can just calculate the angle phi, which is coming to be 64.7 degrees. This is the angle that we obtain after taking the tan tables into account and then calculating the phi value. So once we get this value, phi value is known to us, we know what is the power factor. Power factor is nothing but cos phi. Power factor is equal to cos phi, and therefore cos of 64.7 degrees. This you can just see the cosine tables in your mathematical tables, or you can also use the calculator to get the value, and this comes out to be 0.427. And this is the power factor. So we have got the power fed, power measured by the wattmeter 1, wattmeter 2, and then there is a relationship between the phi and these wattmeter readings in the form of a formula given here, and then make use of this formula and calculate the value of phi by looking at the tables, that is tan tables from the mathematical tables, and then cos phi is the power factor, therefore substitute the value of phi in the cos phi and then look at the value for the cosine, you will be getting this value as 0.427. Therefore we calculated what is the total power fed to the load as well as the power factor of this circuit. Now we can just have another problem related to this power measurement by using two wattmeter method. So the problem reads like this. Two wattmeters have been used to measure the power input to a 150 kilowatts 440 volts three-phase slip ring induction motor running at full load. The wattmeter readings are 115 kilowatts and 50 kilowatts. Right? First thing is power input. To motor, what is the power input? It is basically the readings of the both wattmeters. The readings of the both wattmeters are given as 115 kilowatts, right, and 50 kilowatts. Therefore, the total power will become how much? 165 kilowatts, right? Next is second point. We have already got the relation, that is tan phi is equal to root 3 times W1 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2. So making use of this formula, that is 115 minus 50 divided by 115 plus 50, you will be able to get this value. And from this phi is equal to tan inverse, this value, this comes out to be totally 34.3 degrees. This is the angle. Now from this we can get the cos phi, that is the power factor, which is coming to be 0.826. Phi is calculated by using the same formula. Powers are given W1, W2. W1 is 115 kilowatts, W2 is 50 kilowatts. Substitute them and then simplify them and we find the value of phi by taking this tan inverse of this value. And then this comes out to be 34.3 degrees. And then cos phi is cos 34.3 degrees will give you 0.826 is the value. Then the third important point here is the power input to motor P in must be V3 into root 3 into VL into IL into cos phi. This is the formula. Power input is already there with us, 165 kilowatts, root 3 into VL, load voltage is given, line voltage is given, sorry, not load voltage, line voltage, into line current, I don't know, I want to calculate, cos phi is given as 0.826. Now from this, we can calculate the line current, and this line current is 165 kilowatts, kilo is nothing but 10 to the power of 3, had to add, divided by root 3 into 400, multiplied by 0.826. This, if you make calculation, this current comes to be 262.1 ampere. This is the amount of current that is being drawn by this induction motor supplied with 400 volts, 50 hertz supply, and the power that is supplied is 150 watts. Now, after having made these calculations, so we are asked to calculate what is the power input to the motor, and then what is the power factor, and what is the line current. So after making these three calculations, now we can go ahead with the final calculation that is related to efficiency. So what is efficiency? Let us say this is fourth point. The efficiency of the motor is normally given by efficiency, I am representing by eta letter. There is nothing but output power divided by input power. So output power is how much? It is 150 kilowatts was the output power which is getting, and the input power that is being supplied is 165 kilowatts. Therefore, the efficiency comes out to be 90.9%. So here kilo gets cancelled, 150 by 165, if you take a ratio, the efficiency comes to be 90.9% of this. Therefore, the efficiency of the motor is 90.9%, and the current drawn by the motor is 262.1 amperes, and the cost by power factor is 0.826, and input power is the measurement of the wattmeters we have got, the W1 plus W2, which is 165 kilowatts.